evening, and thank you very much for the invitation to come and talk to you briefly about the hive. We're all used to. There's a couple of pictures there you can see. The hive is a significant investment in young people in Wirral. We've not quite been open a year yet, but it's a state-of-the-art iconic building with a whole range of different activities and support for young people. We operate as an independent charity. We operate as an independent charity, but we are part of a network of youth zones that are growing around the country, which is part of an umbrella charity, if you want, called Onside Youth Zones, which was founded in 2008. And it was founded to replicate the successful model of Bolton Lads and Girls Club. This is a youth club that's been around for over 125 years. And for most of its life, it was what you might imagine of a typical youth club with a leaking roof, a pool table with three legs, and not much more. Back in the late 90s, their building was burnt down and their committee sat round and said, if we were going to build the best youth club in the country, what would it look like? And they came up with this idea, and it was going to cost the best part of 5 or 6 million to build, and it was going to have all sorts of facilities. So they did it, and they dug the heels in, and they raised the money, and they did it. And over the following years, lots of people came to visit from all over the country. So we wish we had one of these in our borough, but nobody actually went away and did it. So the then chairman set up a charity called Onside, which purely has the charitable objective of creating these state-of-the-art projects for young people, of engaging strategically with local authorities, with private sector champions. Onside raises the capital funds, leads on the design and the build, and then at the point that the building is completed, that is handed over to a locally led charity. So Wirral Youth Zone, whilst part of that network, we are an independent local charity with local leadership, very strong private sector-led governance, although representation from local authority, from children's services, from fire, lots of different agencies. Wirral is the eighth of these youth zones to open, but Onside has a real ambitious vision to have 20 live projects by 2020 and 100 by 2030. And is on target for that. Another one will open in Chorley in a couple of months' time, and next year 5 will open, and the charity will go national, which is where I introduce my colleague Tony. Tony has recently been appointed as the chief executive of the upcoming youth zone in Croydon, one of three that will open in London next year. We've been open less than a year, and the Wirral project is viewed as the flagship model. So all the new London chief execs are coming up to learn from Wirral, and are up here. So Tony is up here for 6 months, learning what we do in Wirral, and then replicating that in London. I'm just going to hand over to Tony. He's going to tell you a little bit more about what the youth zone is, the model, what we do, and then I'll come back with a little bit more that's specific to us tonight.
So Stuart's right, I'm an Essex boy living in Birkenhead at the moment, so I'm up here till the summer, and very nice it is too. So what I want to do just very briefly is just go over what we call the youth zone offer. Broadly, the on-site mission and our mission is to provide somewhere to go, something to do, and someone to talk to for children and young people aged 8 upwards, and for those who are 25 if you have additional needs. We're really proud that since 8th of April last year at the Hive, we have maintained every week 46 hours of open access, universal youth provision. That's 7 days a week, and that's been every week of the year since we opened last April. How that works, as the slide says here, as it says, 20 activities each night, buildings that create involvement with children and young people, sports, arts, personal development. There's a climbing wall, there's a boxing ring, there's a music studio. The list just goes on. There's a rooftop football pitch, there's a 4 badminton court sports hall. There's so much to do. We have a really really effective employment and enterprise program. We have an approach called Try, Train, Team, which essentially is we give young people the opportunity to try something new for the first time. We then encourage them to train towards that, and then we encourage them to form teams. And over the past year, we have formed girls' football teams, lads' football teams, netball teams. It just goes on. Tonight, the lads are playing a kebab shop, I believe, as part of a local league group. But these are young people that, you know, since I've been up at the Hive, I've looked at and I thought, what was you doing over 18 months ago? If you weren't here, where were you? And they're now playing football as part of a team. We're inclusive, and we're really proud of that. Every Sunday we have what's called Hiveability, and that is our inclusion sessions for young people up to the age of 25 who may have additional needs. And we regularly receive over 100 young people coming to enjoy our facilities. As the years progress, young people increasingly call it their second home, and we're really passionate about raising aspirations and developing the leaders of tomorrow. Let's go to the next slide. A youth zone is a place that is safe for young people, it's inspiring, it's quality provision. As I said earlier, we work with those aged 8 to 19, up to 25. The model is quite simple, it's just 50 pence per visit, £5 a year annual membership. At the moment, whilst I'm living up here in Birkenhead, I'm using the gym in the morning at the youth zone. It's David Lloyd quality equipment, and I'm able to use that, and so are young people, for 50 pence. It's just a total no-brainer. And we're open when schools are closed. So our sessions start at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, and we close at 10. We run sessions throughout the weekend as well. Just briefly, some impact from young people. We deliver holiday clubs. So during the half-term and summer holidays, for just £10, your child can come to the Hive from 8 o'clock in the morning till 6 in the evening, and they'll get breakfast and lunch, and they'll be able to take part in all of the activities and use the facilities that we have. And just as a kind of anecdotal story, a couple of weeks back, a young lady who we've been working with, she was moving away from the area over Doncaster. She'd been brought up through the care system, and at 10:15 every evening, the staff have a debrief just to reflect on the session, what worked well, what didn't work well. And she came in and she thanked every single one of the members of staff and said that you've changed my life. And it saved her from many horrible things. And in the 5 or 6 weeks that I've been there, that just justified why I joined the organisation. So that's the change that we're making, that's the impact that we're making. Next slide, Stuart. Raising aspirations, we're really determined to do that. I'm really passionate about that. We know through various social studies that young people who grow up in challenging environments where they're facing deprivation and significant barriers, aspirations for them they're not high enough, they need to be higher. We're trying to do that at the Hive. We're trying to raise the aspirations and trying to help young people realise their dreams. We have a young person's development group. So everything we do at the Hive is informed by young people. Rewind, 3 years, Stuart, the young person development group would have been formed, and those young people informed the look of the Hive, the branding, the logos, the activity, and they're still at the heart of the Hive today, informing all that we do. So that's the last of my slide.
Tell somebody else did that bit of the presentation for me. I can't be doing with all those things separately. Anyway, we're all youth zone. Already we have over 7,000 members from young people across Wirral, which does indicate there was a demand for what we're doing. And 80,000 visits from young people. We've created 75 permanent jobs, some full-time, some sessional, although none on 0 hours contracts, I'll add. And we've recruited over 100 volunteers. So far, we have had over 11,500 hours of volunteering given to the project, which equates to a value of well over £100,000 worth of time. And over time, We believe that the Youth Zone will have a significant impact on antisocial behaviour, and indeed we're already seeing that. Just a couple of weeks ago, myself and a colleague from the local police were invited to a Home Office strategy group to talk about the Wirral Youth Zone, which has already been seen as an example of best practice on creating an impact. So we were invited to the Home Office to present on that. And you know, we've already got reductions of antisocial behaviour in the area over 25%, and that's looking to increase further as we go forward. Very much hope working to improve perceptions of young people in the community. Yeah, we've got loads of recreational activities. Young people can have fun and a good time, and that's really important. But also, we're involving young people in giving back as well. I'll come on to a little bit of that on the next slide. And employability and enterprise is a key part of our work as well. Enterprise is a culture within the Youth Zone. We offer bespoke employability programs working with local companies. We're already seeing over two-thirds of the young people who've gone through those programs into work and further education. We're working with young enterprise and developing those skills in a fun and enjoyable way amongst young people. The Youth Zone is about the long term, it's about a journey, it's about preparing young people to achieve their best and reach their potential at adulthood, but it isn't a three-week intervention, it's a journey over a long time. As we've touched on, young people are absolutely at the heart. We mentioned the Young People's Development Group. They were part of the design of the project, the branding. They sat on the panel that appointed the architects. They rejected some of the first design. They came up with the name. Their views and opinions have been sought throughout in various different ways. They're part of the recruitment process for all of the staff in the kind of four-month period between about October and January, just over a year ago. Young people sat on 600 interview panels and really took that to heart, that it was their youth zone, and that they've, you know, it wasn't a tokenistic involvement at all. You know, they actually influenced quite strongly some of the appointments that we made and some that we didn't. I remember one candidate and the young people said to me afterwards, "Stuart, we like you, respect you, but if you appoint that person, we all quit." And they really developed. They started with some standard questions, but as they got into it, they were asking supplementary questions. They were really delving quite deeply. Ongoing consultation and input. We have a young leaders program already. Over 50 young people have been through that 8-week training program, and they're now involved in leading senior young people, involved in leading on junior sessions, on supporting their peers on the inclusion session, volunteering in different ways and linking them into volunteering on other community projects as well, and really kind of embedding that ethos within young people of contributing to their community in various different ways. We have different groups of young people as well that meet regularly and advise us on the program content and all sorts of other aspects of the life of the Youth Zone. Particularly relevant to yourselves here. We are the Wirral Youth Zone. Although we're located in Birkenhead, we are not the Birkenhead Youth Zone. It is a Wirral-wide project. You know, unsurprisingly, we have a higher number of members who live closer. But we work really hard to ensure that the Youth Zone is communicated and available for young people right across the Wirral. So, initially, we had a target of 3,000 members, which was based on the performance of the other youth zones in the network. As I mentioned, we have over 7,000. That has, you know, we've massively overachieved there. It's a very busy project. But we decided that we would, you know, split our target as well. So, you know, we didn't. If we just got 3,000 members from those who lived very locally and could walk, or those whose parents brought them, that to us is not achieving our target. So we've been very proactive in doing as much as we can to promote the project. So within Wirral West constituency, our target was 601 members, and this was based on percentage of population of young people in each area. So in the constituency as a whole, we do have 747 members, so we've achieved that target. Breaking that down by wards, we're not quite there yet in all the wards, and we've got some more work to do. And we have actually got some more money approved in our budget from the 1st of April to increase our outreach team, which is currently one person. He is currently working in a number of schools in this area, and we're starting to do some taster sessions to engage more young people. So, you know, any help you can give us in promoting the project, encouraging young people to get involved, that would be great. Happy to work with any other community groups. So where are we going from here? We're nearly at our first year. It has been something of a roller coaster. The numbers that we've been working with have far exceeded expectation and what was budgeted for. So a lot of team members have been working very, very hard. But what we don't want to do at any point is rest on our laurels and say job done. We recognise that actually we've got so much more to do. So going ahead into the next year, the first thing is about quality of our work and ensuring that it actually has an impact. We've talked about return on investment already tonight, so I'm not going to bring that into it. But you know, one of the things we will be doing quite a lot of in this next year is evaluation of our work. And a major piece of evaluation will start very soon at the end of our first year, so that we can learn from that and ensure that what we're doing actually makes a difference. And we will be looking at those return on investments. Some of those exercises have been done across the other youth zones in the network, but we're going to do that specifically for Wirral as well. And we're really working on being the best at what we do before getting any bigger. We're not looking to grow in any unsustainable way and start lots of new pieces of work that can't be sustained long term. You know, the project, we want to be here for a long time. You know, the intention is that the youth zone will be operating long after I've stopped working. Outreach will form a major part of our work in the coming year. We've talked about geography, ensuring that young people from right across Wirral are able to access the project and take part. But also in terms of diversity as well, and ensuring that our membership is representative of children with disabilities, looked after children, etc. Really making sure that we meet the needs of all young people. And the really big one is partnership and collaboration. Our specialism is generalism. And the only way that we will see young people achieve the best outcomes is if we're working in partnership with lots of different organisations. We've already got partnership agreements with about 40 different organisations, schools, other voluntary sector organisations, statutory services. And we want to do more and more of that. You know, I've put down there that we're looking to address fears. Before we were open, there were a number of fears around the area that we were coming in as quite a large charity and what we were doing would have a detrimental effect on smaller groups in the area. And the reality is the opposite to that, and our intention is to work with as many groups as we possibly can, be they small local groups who might be able to use some of our activities or refer some of young people to things, but also where we would learn a lot from them as well. Different specialist services, we're not there to provide that. And actually by working together, we can become even stronger. So we've worked with a number of organisations on joint bids already, joint activities, and that's starting to build up. And we're very keen to work with even more groups in the best interests of young people. Additionality, the youth zone is very much as well as not instead of all the excellent work that was already going on in Wirral. There are over 45,000, I think, young people in our age range. You know, we're working with 7,000 of them. That still leaves over 38,000. You know, so it's very much about additionality, not about instead of. Really looking to learn from other groups, other organisations, other local people, so that we can improve what we're doing. I think I've already mentioned their joint projects, very much the direction we want to go in. And sustainability, a big issue. We don't want to be here one day and not the next. So we are doing a lot of work to ensure that we maintain what we started with young people. It's very much, I guess in summary, a four-way partnership enables us to do what we do. Young people is one part. The private sector play a huge part in supporting the youth zone, both in terms of financial support and a lot of other engagement. The local authority are you know, our biggest partner, and without the local authority we would not be anywhere near where we are. And the community as well, working with other groups, volunteers we've talked of. You know, each part on its own isn't sufficient. It's all about working together. And I guess that's about us in a nutshell. Very happy to show people around the project if people ever want it, and very happy to take any questions.